Pulse News on the Go, brought to you by Belakwa Mineral Water, proudly Ghanaian.
Ashanti Regional Director of the Electoral Commission, Siribu Okweku, has begun looking at ways voters will be able to be continuously registered up until the election. The Electoral Commission said this will allow Ghanaians who turn 18 at any time within 2016 to register for a voter ID card in any of its district offices. Meanwhile, stakeholders have been urged to probe the background of personnel being recruited by the Commission to conduct next week's limited registration exercise. Mr. Okweku said this was to ensure the personnel conducting the limited registration exercise could not be accused of political bias. Security expert Dr. Kwesi Enin wants those responsible for leaking the report acknowledging a possible terror attack on Ghana punished. The security alert dated April 9 was an internal memo to all heads of security agencies but was leaked and seen by pulse.com.gh. The alert said a possible terrorist attack on Ghana was real, as confirmed by a suspected Malian terrorist under interrogation for the Grand Bassam attacks in Cote d'Ivoire. But Dr. Kwesi Enin said the Ghana Immigration Service, the originator of the memo, needed to investigate the matter and punish anyone found to have leaked the memo. Ghanaian girls who travel to Kuwait to serve as maid servants will no longer be issued with visas, Ghana's ambassador to Saudi Arabia, Alhaji Saeed Sinari, has said. This follows increasing reports of abuse and maltreatment of young girls who go to Kuwait to serve as house helps. In an interview with the Finder newspaper, Ghana's ambassador to Saudi Arabia, Alhaji Saeed, said the issuance of Visa 20 will only resume after Kuwait and Ghana sign a bilateral agreement that streamlines procedures for recruitment and outlines conditions of service to offer better protection to the maid servants. The Public Utilities Regulatory Commission says it will visit the floating production storage and offloading vessel before close of week April 22 to ascertain developments on the rig for itself. This comes after a scheduled two-week mandatory maintenance work was suspended to 5 weeks, ultimately impacting power generation for the country. Technical investigation conducted on the state of the turret bearing on the FPSO revealed it had been damaged, with the Minister of Petroleum, Emmanuel Amakofi Bua, describing it as extensive.
Pulse News on the Go, brought to you by Belakwa Mineral Water, proudly Ghanaian.